When you think of a new feminist, what comes to your mind? Do you think of radical extremists, protests and marches, women wanting to be controlling? By definition, feminism supporting women's equality. Some people believe that feminism is all about power-hungry women becoming superior to men. Maybe that's because they're afraid that women can be just as powerful as men. Maybe it's because all throughout history, males have had the unquestioned power.
This is the time to change history. When we were filming our audition to make this TED Talk, we were sporting some awesome ties. And after we actually figured out how to tie them, we went to check with Layla's mom to see if they looked decent. Now, I specifically remember her asking us why we were wearing ties, because ties are for men and our talk was on what girls could do. At that moment, her mom had proved our point on why we wanted to give a TED speech about equality.
As females supporting equality, we envision a world with fairness to all people. We need to reach the point of equal pay, equal power, and most importantly, equal respect. We really like the quote from Desmond Tutu, "If you are neutral in situations of injustice, you have chosen the side of the oppressor." Until recently, we did not look at feminism as beneficial to everyone. Many people have not seen this point of view either. But everybody needs equality, including males. I would definitely say that things have improved for women over the centuries, but that seems to be the only thing that people want to realize. Yes, we can vote. Yes, we can run for political office. And yes, we can have a job. But why is this seen as such a huge improvement when it is simply righting a wrong?
Now, we have no interest in belittling the work of amazing women like Susan B. Anthony. We need to appreciate people like them and strive to be more like them. What people often lose sight of is that following feminism is not demanding all the equality. There was a survey done, including 11,988 feminists, showing that 74% of them follow the idea of equality, while the other 26% either think women should be superior or inferior to men. This shows that the anti-feminists are using the minority that supported women being superior as an argument against all feminists. This is completely irrelevant because the majority of feminists want equality. The people who want women to be superior are not feminists by definition. Therefore, when people say that women should be superior, that is completely unrelated to the beliefs and goals of feminism. There should not be rivalry over this because nothing is unfair about the concept of equality. In school, we are told to cover our shoulders and legs because they are distracting. We need to take this rule and analyze what it is entailing. Instead of telling us to cover up something that we were born with and everybody has, acknowledge that society is the real problem. It's mind-blowing that the same society that endorses all of this clothing is the society that tells us we shouldn't wear those things. I do believe that the dress code targets girls. In fact, I have been told to change multiple times because my shoulder straps were not thick enough or my skirt wasn't long enough. I remember one time this year, I wore this tank top that my dad had purchased for me. It had cats on it and the straps were modest, and I was still told to cover it up. As girls, we can't help that the clothing designed for us is not deemed appropriate. Why is this restriction one-sided? If solving this problem means covering things up, why don't we start covering up boys' eyes? It seems really uncivilized, but so does the dress code. It is agreeable that if clothing is modest, it should be allowed to wear in school. It is also agreeable that as a society, we should stop over-sexualizing normal body parts.
In America, one out of three females will be or have been harassed. That statistic is not reduced to huge things like human trafficking, but it's smaller acts like catcalls. We all live in the 21st century, but somehow we have almost taken a step backwards in respect for women. And female suffering is not limited to just America. In Egypt, 99.3% of all of the women have said they faced physical harassment. Even verbal harassment has to be stopped. It's not okay to live in a world where women and men are treated differently. If a man harasses a woman, it is seen as terrible. But if a woman harasses a man, the man is shamed. We need to have equality for everyone, no matter the circumstance. It is not okay for anybody to be harassed, no matter the gender. This is a fairly average middle school, and I am constantly hearing things like, men are superior, or, oh, she's a feminist. The teachers attribute these things to the fact that boys will be boys, but these problems are nearly ignored. If these stereotypes are not faced head on, we can't diffuse the problems where they stand. We were first introduced to the idea that women hold less power than males as kids. When we're first introduced to the media, what do we see? We see princesses in need of princes, damsels in distress, women needing saving. As a child, I loved princess movies. Little did I know that my parents were showing me films that insinuated that I needed a man to make my life better. Obviously, that's not what my parents were trying to teach me, and that's probably not what the makers of the film was trying to teach me either. But that is the standard that society sets for women.
In all honesty, the world needs equality for everyone. Nobody should have to live in a world where they are told that they are inferior to someone else. If I have children one day, no matter what gender they are, I will not teach them that they are better than another or that they are inferior to someone else, but that they are equal. Just like my mom, who teaches me and my brothers that it's not okay for anyone of any gender to hit another person. She also teaches me that even if I am a girl, I should hold the door for someone if they need to come through, because it is the polite thing to do. If everyone keeps passing this on to their children, one day things will be better. Not only will things be better for one gender, but for all of them. This is the time to make things better. By better, I mean equal, and by equal, I mean for everyone.